Paul Revere Williams, Architect Extraordinaire. Paul Revere Williams was an American architect. He was a trailblazer in a career that spanned over five decades. Williams designed more than 3,000 structures and mastered a range of architectural styles. His practice was located in Los Angeles, and most of his work was done in Southern California. Exceptionally gifted, he landed internships and jobs at prominent local architecture firms immediately after high school in 1912, despite facing racial prejudice. His high school guidance counselor once told him, "Who ever heard of a Negro being an architect?" Williams was undeterred and continued his quest to become an architect. In 1920, he was appointed to the first Los Angeles City Planning Commission. The following year, he received his certification and license as architect by the state of California. He opened his own practice in 1923, later serving as an architect for the Navy during World War II. Williams designed almost 2,000 homes in Los Angeles alone, many for wealthy businessmen and Hollywood stars. Yet he also designed affordable homes, public housing, and a host of civic, commercial, and institutional buildings. Regardless of style or use, his work reflected the common threads of elegant composition and perfect proportion. Williams was part of the Los Angeles International Airport Planning and Design Team. He was a member of the joint venture office for the entire airport project. Williams masterfully navigated the business and social circles of the day. He even learned to draw upside down in order to sketch for clients from across the table, for the benefit of any white clients who might have been uneasy sitting next to an African American. The world-renowned Beverly Hills Hotel received the Williams upgrade, including its signature pink and green colors and iconic script logo. Many celebrities and public figures sought out his services. Williams pioneered indoor and outdoor living with the use of patios as extensions of the house, hidden retractable screens, sweeping staircases, modernist interior fireplaces, and master suites. As his reputation grew, his practice expanded to include buildings that today are considered landmarks. In the course of his five-decade career, Williams designed thousands of buildings, served on many municipal, state, and federal commissions, earning the admiration and respect of his peers. He frequently donated his time and skills to projects to edify young people, especially African Americans in Southern California. He broke racial barriers, becoming the first African American member of the American Institute of Architects. Williams passed away in 1980 at the age of 85. Despite his legendary status and prolific output, Williams' work is facing increasing threats of demolition or excessive alteration. Until next time, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel. Press the bell to be notified of future uploads. Thank you for watching.